I was at the height of my success running my own business, and 2 months after our wedding day, I found out that I was diagnosed with Hodgkin's lymphoma. 8 months after I finished chemotherapy, I started having trouble breathing. I didn't really find out about the heart failure till after the cardiac arrest. My local hospital was no longer able to do anything for me.
When I first saw her, she was in cardiogenic shock. We couldn't be too optimistic about saving her life. She had to be transferred to NewYork-Presbyterian. She was on the heart and lung machine. This is a solution that lasts only for a few days.
I underwent a surgery that was 12 to 14 hours long, something like that, something crazy.
There are two types of mechanical heart pump. The short-term ELVA, the mechanical pump, requires a smaller operation, and the patient can sit in a chair, maybe make a few steps, but has to stay in the hospital. 20 years ago, a heart transplant was the only option. If a heart would not have become available in time, a patient would die.
Because I had the Hodgkin's lymphoma, they needed to put 5 years in between when I was diagnosed to being in remission. Because with a heart transplant, you're gonna be put on the immunosuppressants.
The heart pump sits next to the heart and draws the blood from the heart into the bigger vessel, the aorta. The pump is connected through a drive line that exits the body to a controller system. Both pump and controllers are powered by two external batteries, which last more than 12 hours.
It is a miracle that this device even existed at the time that everything happened, because I would not be alive today without it. I was able to actually go to yoga class 3 times a week on the LVAD in order to strengthen my body so I was ready for a heart transplant.
Luckily, a donor heart became available for Sherry. And thanks to this gift, she's now alive.
Organ donation is so important. It's my mission now. I can't thank my heart donor, but I can give back. And that's my purpose.
NewYork-Presbyterian is a unique place. We have been leaders in the field for a long time. The first heart transplant took place in this institution 40 years ago. And the first mechanical pump was implanted more than 25 years ago. And we never give up.
It's hard to find the words for New York Presbyterian. The phrase, amazing things are happening here, it's so true, it's incredible.